Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking us to give a loan that he will multiply, a good loan, qarza hasana, that he will multiply and give us back multiple times. And so I just want to pause here and ask you guys, and I want to understand who will answer me, what is the meaning of giving loan to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You all know the meaning of loan, right? So loan naturally means that there is a person who has something, he gives a loan to the other person, and the other person has to return that loan, right? Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah is saying, who will give amongst the righteous people, among the believers, who will give a good loan to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can return it to that person in multiplied, magnified way, and in this life as well as hereafter. So what is the meaning of this loan to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Who will tell me? Yes, go ahead. I see a raised hand.
Sir, can I?
Yes, please go ahead.
Sir, the meaning of loan is like when you give charity to when you give charity, so it's like a loan to Allah, and then he multiplies it and then gives it to you back.
Excellent answer. Thank you so much. Yes, this is the meaning of this. That, you know, when we are giving charity, we are thinking that when we will give something out, it will become less. Our money will become less. Let's say you have 100 rupees or riyals or dollars in your wallet. Somebody comes and they ask you, you know, I'm in need of money and all of this. Now you will give back, let's say you will give a $10 or a $20, whatever, or a riyal or rupees, you will give them. What happens is, for that moment, you feel I have helped someone and I've given someone and my money has become less, right, from the amount that I've given. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, and what you rightfully answered as well, is that whenever you give this charity, or whenever you do good deed, or whenever you spend your life in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is returned as it is returned, multiplied, and you get a lot of bounties in this life as well as hereafter. So excellent answer. I want to also explain this point with an example. So imagine there's a father who gives a bag of sweets to his little kid. So there's a little kid, a boy or a girl, and this is his father who, you know, gave a big bag of sweets. And then he asks for just one sweet, and he asks his child, can I please have that one sweet from you? What do you think is happening? What do you think the father is doing? And what is really happening here? So the father gave the sweets to the child, obviously, because normally kids don't have their own money, right? So the kid was very happy and they received their sweets and they are now super happy. Now the father asks them, or someone elder in the family asks them, can I have that sweet? Can I have the little sweet? So what do you guys think is happening? I'm sure it would have happened to you guys as well. What is really happening here? Yes, Shayan, go ahead.
So basically, this is the same situation with us and Allah Ta'ala, that we are dependent on him. So just like the kid is dependent on his parents or his dad who gave him the sweets, so Allah is like that to us. He's giving us everything. So all of the things we have is like the bag of sweets. And all he's asking from us is to give some of that in his for him, to spend it for him, or use what he has given us for his purpose. So that's basically what it is.
Excellent answer, Shayan. Excellent. Yes, you're right. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us everything in this world. He has given us the wealth. He has given us the money, everyone, food, everything that we feel so proud of that it is ours, right? Actually, it is given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We saw and we learned this concept in the previous lessons as well. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us everything, in the Quran, he's saying, who is it who would give me a nice loan or a qarza hasana? So it is, you know, it is, we should be really, as Muslims, we should be even ashamed for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stating it in this way, because everything is his that he has provided. So if there is a need, or if there's someone who comes and asks us for help, we should give it more. And you know, because he's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Rabb, and he loves us. So he's saying, out of everything that I've given you, even if you spend a little or whatever you will spend in my name, or, you know, in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he would give us the reward multiplied. So it's like you are given a bag of sweet and your father is asking, can I have that one little sweet? And, you know, And just to check you how much you love him, by the way, the dad even probably doesn't even need sweet, right? He doesn't want it. He's just checking the child, just teasing the child. And then imagine the child getting, I don't know, 10 bags of sweets or even something bigger than that. So this is the example. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us everything. And in this ayah in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that, is there someone who would give me this qarza hasana or give me this nice loan? It's an amazing loan and a nice loan because I will return back it multiplied. While you will think that I am spending it right now and I'm giving or helping someone, my money is getting less. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying later on, you will get it multiplied. If you're doing a job, you will be promoted. If you have a shop, you will get multiple shops or whatever will happen. And at the end, obviously in the akhirah, you will have a lot of sawab, a lot of ajr, a lot of rewards that are waiting for you. Why? Because you spend your life, your money, your wealth, your everything in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he asked you in the Quran as a guidance to do that. So this is one of the key messages that we should remember. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself is the provider of everything. He does not need a loan. Action for us, or the point that we need to do is, we need to understand is, it is for our own good in this life and akhirah, which is the afterlife. And based on all the good deeds that we do to help others, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us. And by the way, we need to understand that we are only the khalifa here. We are just a guardian, and we have to, you know, spend and all, because we cannot really take our wealth and money with us. So we cannot even take it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it in the first place. So we should better use it to help others. I hope this point is clear for everyone.